going on? I'm Samantha, SARKAZZ here on YouTube. If it's your first time tuning in, hope you enjoyed this video. Click that subscribe button. Hey, and don't forget to click that thumbs up so you, click the notification bell so you know when I post. Now, as you can see from the title, I'm gonna talk about living with eczema. Yes, in different vlogs I've talked about it jokingly and stuff like that, but living with eczema is no joke. First and foremost, where should I begin? It itches like a mofo. Oh my gosh. And the reason why I said I decided to do this video, because I'm, you know, I've posted different things on other social media sites and, you know, talking about the different creams I may have used or soaps, and, you know, people chime in. So you see that other people are dealing with this, their children, and, you know, it's good to get feedback and try different things that may help you or someone living with eczema. 2002 is when I was diagnosed with it, and I first noticed a spot was on my hand. Now you can see that there's one here, but usually it's here, and I mean, it started off small like this, then it started to grow, and I'm like, what the heck is going on? So that's when I sought out a dermatologist, and that's when I found out. And it was itching, and you know, I'd scratch it and it would be get inflamed, and it was just very gross. And yeah, I wanted to know what it was, and that's how I found out, 2002. Now, I have atopic eczema. There's different types, and so atopic eczema is the one that I deal with. Atopic dermatitis, also called eczema, and it's an itchy inflammation of the skin. So it's like a red, itchy, scaly rash. Well, on black folk, it's not red. It's dark, and yeah, not pretty. Growing up, I mean, I knew, you know, I grew up with someone that had it, and it was bad. I didn't know that's what it was then. You know, as you get older, you know, you young kids are cruel. You know, I was part of it, I ain't gonna lie, but you don't understand things, and you know, you get older and you experience the same shit, you're like, oh, okay, that's what it was. And I complain about the areas where it is. I mean, I showed you, you know, I just showed the spots on my leg, I showed my hand. Those are the parts of my body, I ain't showing that shit. No, we ain't doing that. But it can be, what's the word I want to use? It's not embarrassing. It's I'm self-conscious about it, especially like the one on my hand, because I mean, sometimes I'm talking to people, or like even when I do a video and I see my hand, I'm like, I wonder what people thinking, what that is, whatever. Eczema, shit. That's what it is. But then they see this commercial now, and it ticks me off. Like, it's a person, like, different social events, and then you hear say, oh, it's eczema. Oh, I'm fine. Oh, it's eczema. I'm fine. No, you can live your life. You just have to find out what triggers you off, what you can use when you have flare-ups. It's manageable. Trust me. I know I have flare-ups. You have to know what your flare-ups are. And I realized, and a friend of mine brought it to my attention, one of my big stress, what makes me flare-up, is stress. Stress.
Stress.
And, yeah. And I had a big flare-up not long ago, but then that stress has gone, and I'm good. I'm not saying I don't itch every now and then, and especially at nighttime, this one on my right leg, I'd be like, son of a bitch. I've scratched so much, you can see. If you saw, you can now, my pigmentation is gone. Shit! I didn't wear shorts before, now hell to the no! I mean, my shorts was, you know, was always like a little bit below my knee, so, but those two spots, I mean, I could always say I cut and fell down and cut myself and just mark up my skin, whatever. But, I mean, it makes you self-conscious because, you know, you don't like it on yourself, so you wonder what other people are thinking. So, over the years, I've had to change products, because as you grow, your skin changes, your skin gets used to certain products, and it's no longer effective. So, it's all about finding what works for you, and being strict on those products. For me right now, shea butter is heaven sent. Just raw shea butter. It smooths out the roughing, because really rough patches, it smooths it out. No itching for the most part. When it comes to clothes, I stick to cotton. I mean, I wear jeans, yeah. But I don't wear jeans. I've never worn jeans that are tight fitting, and I never will. Not just because of eczema, I just know, but especially now with eczema, because you know, stuff rubbing on it is irritating. I was in the gym the other day. Even my sweatpants aren't tight, but it was rubbing on the one that's on my thigh. And oh my God, I'm like, yo, my leg is on fire. But I kept on working out, held the pants off of my skin and finished that workout. And you know, the sweat and all that, it can be a real hassle, but it is manageable. Yes, I put it across the screen. I have one prescribed ointment, but that's for like if the flare-up is really, really bad. So it's not something I use often. It's no steroids in this. You know, the years past, I've had used stuff with steroids in it. For me, I don't recommend it. It's not something. Again, if you know someone that's dealing with eczema, you know, don't stare. If you have questions, ask questions. I mean, that's with anything. If you don't understand something, ask questions. We already self-conscious about this shit. You know, like someone saw scratches on a part of our body and it was like, oh, you were scratching your back. No shit, Sherlock, the shit itches. It's like, don't point out shit that always, don't point out, we already self-conscious about this shit. Don't do it. Don't do it. Anyway, I just wanted to share that. Hopefully, all the products that I've shown, they're down below. So if you want to check them out for yourself, you can go ahead and do that. Yeah, I just wanted to come in here and share another part of me. Yeah, live with eczema, and I'm out.